Hey guys, Alex from 7th Hour Films back again with My Hero Academia. Last time on My Hero Academia, we had Match 3 Conclusion. As the name would imply, Match 3 concluded. No, I'll give more recap. So, let's see. Ito was using his Recipro Turbo and zooming all over the place. The animation also went up as he got faster. Ojiro was dealing with Spinny Boy, Shoji was doing an Aura Aura Barrage against Pony, and Todoroki was dealing with Tetsu Tetsu, and he was also starting to increase the power of his fire, potentially getting to the Flash Fire Fist. At least that's my theory of what he's specifically doing. The match, however, ended in a draw. Neither Class A or Class B won that one, so the score is still pretty even. So yeah, we are now moving on into Match 4, which is Team Bakugo versus Team Recommended Girl. I don't remember her name. It was like Takake or something? Tigake? Something. I'll figure it out later. But yeah, that is basically that. So, like always, the reaction is down in the description and in the pinned comment for your viewing pleasure. So let's go ahead and get right into this episode of My Hero Academia. Here we go. That match is exactly what I needed. Without going too much into it, let's just say I watched a very intense episode of Attack on Titan, but now I'm good. I needed a breather, and that was definitely a breather. Oh, goodness me, Bakugo. Character growth at its finest. Oh, man. Friend... You know, by the way, real quick, because I'm thinking about it. I said right at the end of the reaction there, I said, oh, let's hope the predecessors don't fuck with Deku during this fight, you know? And I thought, like, well, I mean, what could they possibly do? I'm not really sure. He just goes into a vision, you know, in the middle of the fight. It's entirely possible. They don't have the greatest timing. But I thought, you know, it would be fucking awesome if they pulled a Roku, Avatar Roku. Remember in... And this is like slight spoilers, if, I guess, if you haven't seen Avatar, but it was in the first season at the Winter Solstice when Roku comes out and attacks the Fire Nation and stuff for Aang. Wouldn't that be some shit if that happened? Like fucking Shimura shows up and starts beating the shit out of Monoma. God, that'd be so satisfying. But I don't think that's going to happen. So, I don't know. There's a part of me that thinks something's gotta happen. This can't just be a straightforward match. Something's gotta happen with Deku. They don't set up the whole, the predecessors reaching out to him without it coming back in this arc, you know? They set it up at the beginning, it's gotta follow through. But, more to the point of this episode, Bakugo, he protect, he attack, and they help. It's amazing. So, Bakugo. Going head on. Not waiting back. But, I like what he says. You know, it's such a strange thing with Bakugo. You know, and I've been rewatching some other episodes where, like... Remember in the provisional license exam, during the rescuing, when those two people are like, oh, rescue us. And he was like, shut up. Save yourselves. And it's like, oh, no. Why would he do that? But then they were like... Well, wait a minute, we're supposed to be low priority. Did he think that through? It's such a weird thing where it's like, you always have to decipher Bakugo's anger. And then you get the point. Like, it's so interesting. But yeah, it's like, you know, on a surface level here, it sounds like, well, Bakugo's just going to go fight and that's just that. And he's going to win. But when you start to decipher it, it does work. Doing an all-out assault does actually work because their quirks are not quite suited for the all-out assault, you know? Especially Togeke, who has to, you know, go and regenerate her body, you know? So yeah, that is pretty interesting, you know? going in for an all-out assault, but also helping each other, supporting each other in that. So I like that. Now, they, correct me if I'm wrong, they never used the grenades, which is interesting. That entire fight, they never used those grenades. Like, they set it up, but then they don't do anything with that. But I like that, you know, because Bakugo is still, you know, so determined, he still has that same resolve of, I want to beat All Might. I want to surpass All Might and be the number one hero. Well, what does that mean? That does mean saving people. At first, he thought that just meant power. But now, over the course of, you know, the show, he has learned. And now it is, yes, fight, win, save people to win, win by saving people, you know? And so he is working together with his team. And it is still a matter of they have to keep up, but it is, you, that is a definite, you have to keep up. Not just because Bakugo is fast, but because it's part of the teamwork. So I like that. That was all really, really good. And yeah, he protect and he attack. That was really good. So yeah, I like that, where he did actually acknowledge, if you're in trouble, I will come save you. If I'm in trouble, you come save me. So that was really good. I mean, it's strange because that's just teamwork. On a fundamental level, that is just how teamwork works. But when he says it, it's like, oh, okay, that's our plan. That's how we do this. But that's the thing, is that the other team wasn't expecting that. They were expecting the old Bakugo. So, yeah. So, I like that. I really do like that. That he, when they're about to hit Jiro, he goes in. Yes, you know, they say, well, he kicked her in order to save her. But he did save her. I mean, it is basically just like getting her out of the way to save her. And it's the same thing that Midoriya did to Bakugo when they fought All Might. Was, you know, All Might was about to hit Bakugo, so Midoriya punched him out of the way and saved him, basically. So that works. That was really, really good. And yeah, so they went for a 4-0, a complete 4-0 with no injuries on their team, and that is exactly how it went down, which was really, really great. I also like how they mention being in the band loosened him up, which they were practicing in that band for a month before the festival. So I like that. That is very true, because he is working with others, but he is still competitive and aiming for the top. And that is exactly what we saw in with the festival and the band, you know? So that is really, really good. Interesting quirks we have on the B team, literally the B team, B4. And so we have Togekiss, who can split her body into 50 fragments. That is terrifying. So yeah, so there's that. I like how they do say, good moment for Sarah when he figures that shit out. And he's like, you know, at a point, those fragments start to lose power, and so she needs to regenerate her body so all the pieces regain energy and she can send them out again. So he starts wrapping them up so they can't reach her body again, which is very good. And then he follows one of those pieces back in order to find her. Very, very clever. We also had the one blade guy, which was interesting. I mean, he was a really interesting design, you know? Which, his whole thing is, you know, blades come out. He's like cars, basically. He's got blades that can come out of any appendage, basically. But I love his design, too, because you gotta think, well, that's just another Tokoyami thing, where, why is Tokoyami a bird if his quirk is Dark Shadow? Well, clearly, one of his parents was a bird, and the other parent had Dark Shadow. That's how that works, you know? So, clearly, with Knife Guy, one of his parents had the knife, you know, the blade ability, and the other parent looked like a friggin' crazy-ass punk lizard with, you know, with these giant fangs and stuff. So, I love stuff like that, where it's like, it's a dual quirk, but not a dual quirk, you know? And that's exactly the same as Tokoyami. Tokoyami, his quirk is Dark Shadow. But technically, he also does have a bird head. That's part of his quirk. It's just a bird head, and that's it. It's the same thing with Coda, where Coda looks like that because we saw his mother looks like that. But presumably, his father has a similar quirk to his Anna voice. So yeah, it is something like that. Now, granted, I suppose it's also entirely possible that the same parent has both of those things and passes it on. Because as we saw with Mirio and his father had the same permeation quirk, but he looked exactly, you know, he got the Tintin eyes going like Mirio does. So I guess that's entirely possible. You know, like Tokoyami's dad. Maybe Tokoyami's dad has. Sorry, I heard a squeak. Please tell me, for the love of God, that is just my chair. Okay. I heard a very loud squeak. A squeak that could potentially come from an animal, but I think it's just my chair. I don't see anything, so I'm just going to assume it was my chair. What was I saying? Okay, yeah, so it's entirely possible that Tokoyami, like, let's say his father has a bird head and something like Dark Shadow, and his mother was just a normal person, you know? Could be. Could be. And then we also got the return of Weld Boy, the welder, who we saw in the training camp. I remember him. He was with Yayorozu, and he was the one who welded the tracker onto the Nomu, which allowed them to find the factory, which was pretty cool. So good to see him. And then the other one was the glue guy. He was kind of interesting. I remember him from the sports festival because he was such a crazy design. But yeah, so his quirk is glue. I think was he on Monoma's team? He might have been on Monoma's team. I can't fully remember, but yeah, so interesting to see all of them and how their quirks work and stuff. But then they were able to swiftly capture all of them, and that was that. That was that. I can't believe how fast that match was, you know? They even say it's like that was barely 5 minutes. Like that was incredible, and I really like that. That it's like, look, they just go. Why Bakugo and the rest of the team? Like it was a solid team, and Bakugo was in on, you know, teamwork and everything. So that was really great. And then we have the upcoming match 5, the final match. It's impossible for Class B to win at this point, but they could potentially tie if they win. Now, we were talking about last episode how we would, you know, how would you do this? So we said it's possible that match 4 would end in Class B's victory so that Class A could tie at the end. But now Class A has the advantage. So do I think they'll lose? I'm not sure. It's entirely possible they could win, and it would basically be a sweep, basically, of Class B. But it's entirely possible that Class B could win, and it will end in a tie, at least. So, I don't know. I'm not really sure how the match will go. I said, you know, oh, well, it's Midoriya, he's the main character, you would think he would win, but we've seen in this show before, just because he's the main character does not mean he will win. So, yeah, I'm interested to see. Because he's definitely on an interesting team, you know. I like how they say he's a lot like Bakugo in that match where he is the trouble for Class B. Because the rest of them, while they have, you know, good quirks, they are not powerhouses like Midoriya is. So, and he's got so many different moves. He's got his arms, he's got his air force, he's got his shoot style. And they can't count on his predecessors screwing up. They don't know about any of his predecessors. But I like Shinso even acknowledges that, you know, he was able to break out of my brainwashing once before. But I like how they say, you know, the plan we know for 5B right now is that they're going to try to brainwash Midoriya long enough for Monoma to copy his quirk. But I like even Monoma is not sure how well that will work, copying Midoriya's quirk, you know? Does that give him the full power of One For All? If it does, boy's gonna break his arm. He might do some damage, definitely. Yeah, we've seen how powerful, you know, One For All is at 100%, you know, and especially just within Deku, which we saw a lot of at the sports festival, and then against Muscular, and also when we saw it continuously against Overhaul. But still, that could potentially backfire on Monoma. So, I don't know. Monoma, after Bakugo's victory, Monoma actually got a little better. I thought that was interesting. You know, I like how, you know, he doesn't berate his classmates or anything, and he does show he cares about his classmates. It's very strange, actually. But that whole speech he had was actually good, and him talking with his team and discussing how to take on Team Midoriya was very interesting. So, yeah, I'm very interested to see where we're going with this. So, yeah, that is basically it. With all that being said, I'm Alex from 7th Hour Films, and I will see you guys next time. Take care. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video. If you want to watch more of my My Hero Academia reactions, there is a playlist on screen, as well as another video you can go check out if you want to check out more videos from me. There's a subscribe button and a Patreon button, as well as other links in the description if you want to go check out any of those. See you guys next time.